The First Corps arrived on the field and routed the Rebs in detail. The old 56th Pennsylvania claimed to get the first volley into the Graybacks. Soldiers had a sense that this was just the beginning.
As the day went on, men on both sides threw more lambs into the slaughter. The perfection in killing by this point of the war was ghastly to behold. It was systematic. Every shot seemed to hit its intended target. The defending Yankees, lying behind brows of hills or behind crude works, would have the advantage on this field.
The Iron Brigade, those fine Westerners with their tall army hats, came into the field and captured Rebel General Archer. It was with a cost, however. The men lost their beloved General Reynolds, who was shot from his horse, while almost upon Archer's brigade of Johnnies.
The first encounter that morning was as a clash of strapping pugilists, feeling the strength of punch of the other. Our regiment had even gained ground and were about to turn their position, but The Yankees had different ideas and soon had our men trapped and on the run. One regiment, the 26th North Carolina, led by a 21-year-old wildcat, Colonel Burgoyne, led his 800 men as if on parade into the vaulted Black Hat Brigade of Westerners. After fighting 30 yards, almost 600 of his men were killed or wounded, and the colonel himself mortally stricken.